Our next program is going to be to find the area of a triangle using Heron's formula. We took a look at this problem earlier, but we did not check whether an input triangle is valid or not. Suppose I give the input as 3, 4 and 2, okay? This one will work because the sum of any two sides is greater than the third side. But suppose I give 3, 5 and 8, this is an invalid triangle because the sum of any two sides is not greater than the third side. So we will write a program now taking care of all the conditions to see that only an input triangle which is valid, we go ahead and calculate the area of that particular triangle. So in order to develop the code for that, I need three variables called as A, B and C which represent the sides of a triangle. I require another variable called as area to hold the result of calculating the area, and I need S which is the half perimeter in Heron's formula to calculate A plus B plus C divided by 2. So the first step is I am going to ask the user enter the three sides of a triangle. Enter the value of three sides. Alright. So once the user enters the three sides, I am going to use a scanf to store the values of these three sides. Sorry, this should be %d%d. Alright. And it's going to be address of A, comma, address of B, comma, address of C. So the values of the three sides are going to be read into three variables or three memory locations with the name A, B and C. Now the next step is I need to calculate the half perimeter. Half perimeter is the total of the three sides plus, the total of three sides divided by 2. Alright. Since all of them are floating point numbers, I do not need to make it as 2.0, but just on the safer side and for clarity that A, B, C as well as S are real or floating point numbers, I am putting 2.0. Now, I can calculate the area using the formula, alright? I have not done the validations yet. I'll show you when to do the validations. First, I'm writing the logic, then I'll do the checking. Then what I'm going to say is area is, alright, square root of S into S minus A, alright, into S minus B into S minus C. Alright. So area of a triangle using Heron's formula is S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. So before I go ahead and utilize this particular library function called as square root, I need to ensure that I have declared a header file called as math.h, because math.h contains the prototype or model declaration of this particular function called as square root. Now, next step what I'm going to do is I'm going to say printf area is 6.2f so that I get accurate up to two decimal places, 6.2f, all right, and I'm going to say area. Now, so far this code will work fine when I am giving valid triangle. But let's try to run this and try to give invalid triangle or give a sides which do not form an invalid, which do not form a valid triangle. So if I click on run, it's giving me a number of errors, which is rightly so. So do not ignore the errors. Click on stop here. These are all floating point. By mistake, I have typed as %d. So this should be %f, %f. And this should also be %f. So just be sure you use the right data types for reading, otherwise you're going to get garbage inputs into the memory location and the program is not going to work. Now let's try to run and compile it. Okay, so what I will do is I will start by giving invalid sides of a triangle. So suppose I give the sides 3, 4 and 8. This is not going to form a triangle because the sum of any two sides, 3 plus 4, is not greater than 8. So you will see that the value of S is going to turn out to be negative in this particular formula because S is going to be some value A plus B plus C by 2. Okay, so this is going to be negative, then this is going to be negative, this may be positive. But when you send a negative value to square root, the square root function does not like a negative value. Sorry, so let me try to run this particular code. So here it says area is NA, and that means you have tried to give a negative number to a square root. Why did you get this error? Because we were trying to attempt to calculate the area of a triangle where the sides were not conforming to the condition where the sum of any two sides should be greater than the third side. So how do we avoid that particular problem? I am going to use the if statement. Here what I am going to say is A plus B should be greater than C, as well as B plus C should be greater than A, and finally this should be A plus B greater than C, B plus C greater than A, okay, and most importantly and lastly, A plus C greater than B. Alright, so now if you see, this condition states that the sum of any two sides must be greater than the third side. Only then I would be required to go ahead, calculate the area of the triangle, and then print the result. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write an if statement, okay, like this. And only if you enter a valid triangle, or only if you enter the sides which lead to the formation of a valid triangle, it is going to go ahead and calculate the area of a triangle. Else it's going to come up with a message. I'm going to print a message: sides do not form a valid triangle. All right, so this is what I am going to do here. Sides do not form a valid triangle, and I am going to terminate this else with the flower brace. So before we go ahead and try to execute it, it requires a little bit of understanding, but this logic is exactly the logic which has been taken from the algorithm which has been discussed earlier. The algorithm, or the link to the algorithm, is going to be provided in the description section of this particular video. So what I have declared is, I have declared three variables called as A, B and C. A, B and C represent the three sides of a triangle respectively. Area is used to hold the area of a triangle. S is the half perimeter. So first I am going to ask the user, enter the value of the three sides of a triangle. Then I am going to read the value of A, B and C. Now Heron's formula says that I need to find the area of a triangle, but I also need to verify that the input sides lead to a valid triangle. What does the rule for a valid triangle say? The rule for valid triangle says the sum of any two sides must be greater than the third side. So A plus B must be greater than C, B plus C must be greater than A, and A plus C must be greater than B. Only when all of this is true, then I am going to go ahead, calculate the area and print the area. Suppose A plus B is greater than C, but then assume B plus C is not greater than A, then it will say sides do not form a valid triangle. Alright, this is an extra brace I am removing here. So in order to understand this particular piece of code, let me try to run the logic and try to see what happens. First, I will give an invalid triangle. I am going to say 2, 3 and, okay, sum of any two sides should be greater than the third side. Okay, so let's say 2 plus 3, I'll put it as 5. Okay, here the sum of any two sides is not greater than the third side, it's equal to the third side. So what is going to happen? It says sides do not form a valid triangle. So what I need to do here now is I need to give a correct input. So what I'm going to do for that is, in order to give a correct input, okay, so the spelling of triangle also, I'll change it as I do it here. So now I'll try to run this particular program giving a correct input. So just see what happens here now. So let's give an correct input. Let's say one side is 3, one side is 5, and let's say the other side is just happens to be 6. Now if you see, the sum of any two sides, 5 plus 3 is greater than 6, 6 plus 5 is greater than 3, 6 plus 3 is greater than 5. So this is input, or this input is a valid triangle. So now if I click enter, it should calculate the area correctly. So it's giving area as 7.48. So I hope you are able to make sense of this particular piece of code. Any of the same code is going to be available in the description of this particular video. So you can take a look at it, play around, modify, and try to get a hang of it. So the most important part is, I use this if to ensure that The input sides provided by the user lead to a valid triangle. If I try to give input which is not a valid triangle, the square root will be sent a negative number, and square root cannot be calculated for a negative number because the triangle also happens to be an invalid or a meaningless triangle, or a triangle which cannot be developed or ever drawn. And then in that case, when it's perfect, it will print the area and then you will come back to alt.